In this video, we will solve the following problem, that is find VC at 1 millisecond. So here we have to find voltage at 1 millisecond across this capacitor. Okay. So there are two voltage sources here, one is 3 volt here, another one is 5 u of minus t. So meaning for t less than 0 only this voltage source is active and its value is 5 volt. For t greater than 0 this source is not active, so voltage source value will be 0 volt when t is greater than 0. Okay. And we have one switch here. At t equal to 0, it will move from position A to position B. Okay. So, and we have 3 resistors and 1 inductor. Current passing through the inductor is IL. Voltage across capacitor is VC. Okay. So, let us start with the first step. The first step is we have to draw the circuit for t less than 0 and t greater than 0. So we will write that for t less than 0. So t less than 0. So what is the circuit here? The position of the switch will be at A. So this capacitor belongs to this part of the circuit. Okay. And we have a separated here part, that is inductor, voltage source and resistor. Okay. So we can divide in 2 parts here. So in the first part we have 3 volt 50k and this switch is connected to this side, so I can directly write like this. So this is 10 micro and voltage across that is VC. This is position A actually. Okay. And position B here, we have inductor and this voltage source will be active since it is 5 u of minus t. So this voltage source is active for t less than 0. So active means I have to write plus minus 5 volt. And you have a resistor here 500 and current passing through this is IL. This is for t greater than 0, sorry, for t less than 0. Now for t greater than 0 switch position will be in the, it will move from A to B. So then this capacitor will be linked to this part of the circuit. This part of circuit we have only 3 volt, 50k and 100k, so we don't need for that analysis. We have RLC circuit in the right hand side. So we will consider only this part of the circuit, that is t greater than 0 you have a capacitor and inductor and a resistor. And this well is 2500 and this is 10 micro and this voltage is VC, current passing through inductor is IL, and we will name this current also IC and this current is IR. Since we need IC of 0 plus further, because to calculate 2 constant we need IC of 0 plus also. Okay, we'll see that later. So this is t greater than 0. Okay, now we will start with step 1. Step 1, t greater than 0, it is parallel RLC. So parallel RLC circuit, you find first alpha, that is 1 by 2RC. If you substitute and find, it will be 100. It is 100 per second. Okay, and omega naught, if you calculate, it is 1 by root LC. So 1 by root LC, if you calculate, it will be 223.6 radian per second. So from this we can see that omega naught is greater than alpha, so response is underdamped. Underdamped response. Underdamped response. And we need omega d. Omega d is omega naught square minus alpha square under the square root. So this value will be 200. Okay. This is step 1. Step 2. Step 2. We have to find step 2, that is VC of, so VC of 0 minus, you have to calculate. So we will see that circuit first. VC of 0 minus, what is the open circuit voltage across this capacitor, or at t equal to 0 minus, what is the voltage across this capacitor? This capacitor will act like a open circuit. So what is the voltage across this? Is nothing but voltage across 100k. So easily from voltage divider rule we can calculate. So VC of 0 minus, so VC of 0 minus is 3 volt into 100k divided by 100 plus 50, 100k plus 50k. So that is nothing but 2 volt. And we have to calculate one more initial condition, that is IL of 0 minus. So I at t equal to 0 minus, the inductor will act like a short. So current passing through the inductor is this voltage, that is 5 volt divided by this resistance 500. So that you will get the current passing through this. Okay. So 5 by 500, that is IL of 0 minus is 5 by 500, that is 0.01 ampere. Okay. So next one, VC of 0 plus, that is nothing but VC of 0 minus, so that you will get 2 volt itself. And IL of 0 plus is nothing but IL of 0 minus, so that is 0.0. So IL of 0 minus, that will be equal to 0.01 ampere. Okay. So next one, step 3. So step 3. So we know the response here from alpha and omega naught value. The response will be underdamped. Since it is underdamped response, it will take the form of VC of D equal to e power minus alpha t into B1 cos omega dt plus B2 sin omega dt. Sin omega dt. Okay. So here alpha value we have already calculated. From the initial condition, that is VC of 0, 0 plus, the value is 2 volt, and you substitute t equal to 0 in the above equation, it will be e power 0 into B1 cos 0 plus B2 sin 0. So cos 0 will be 1, so it will be B1. So B1 value we have calculated, that is 2. Now step 4, we need one more constant. So step 4, if you see, how we can calculate one more constant? Simply by differentiating dVc by dt and equating it to t equal to 0 plus. That is nothing but Ic of 0 plus divided by C. So Ic of 0 plus we can calculate since we know IL of 0 plus. Okay. So if you differentiate this one, this equation, if you differentiate and when you equate t equal to 0 plus what you will get? So it is nothing but b2 omega d minus b1 alpha you will get. You just see that you differentiate first with respect to time and then you substitute t equal to 0, then you will get this b2 of d, and b1 will substitute later here. B1 value is 2, that we have to substitute here. So you will get this value. That value is nothing but IC of 0 plus divided by C. Now we will see what is IC of 0 plus. So IC of 0 plus, let us go back to that circuit. This one, IC of 0 plus, from Kirchhoff's current law, you can easily calculate. This is IC of 0 plus is minus of IL of 0 plus plus IR of 0 plus. IL of 0 plus we know, we had already calculated it. But what about IR of 0 plus? Since we know VC of 0 plus, we simply divide that VC of 0 plus divided by 500, you will get the IR of 0 plus. Okay. So from this we can see that IC of 0 plus is equal to minus IL of 0 plus plus IR of 0 plus. Okay. So we will, and this is nothing but minus IL of 0 plus, we know that, we will substitute that later. IR of 0 plus, what is IR of 0 plus? VC of 0 plus, that is VC of 0 plus divided by 500. So this is nothing but IC of 0 plus. So we will substitute the same thing here. So this is IC of 0 plus is minus IL of 0 plus plus VC of 0 plus divided by 500. Okay, so that value you will get here. So if you substitute now, minus, this is 0.01 plus VC of 0 plus, we already know it is 2 by 500, and if you substitute that, so that you will get here, this is 4 milli, this is 10 milli. So together it is minus 14 milliampere. Okay. Now in this equation, you substitute this one in this equation. So B2 value, we have to calculate that B2, and omega D value. Omega D value, see that here. Yes, 200. It is 200. So omega D value is 200. 200. 200. Then minus B1 value we already know, that is 2 into alpha. Alpha is 100. So alpha is 100. Just let us see. Alpha is 100, correct. So you write that alpha 100. So now this will be equal to, this will be equal to this side, IC of 0 plus, that is minus 14 milliampere divided by capacitance. Capacitance is 10 micro. So if you simplify this, you will get B2 equal to minus 6. You will get minus 6. So this is about the step 4. Now, step 5 we will write. So question asked is, we want to calculate VC at a particular time, that is 1 millisecond. Before that, we should have an expression for VC of t. Later we will substitute t equal to 1 millisecond. So VC of t is e power minus alpha t, that is minus 100 t, into B1. B1 value we know, it is 2 cos omega d. Omega d is 200 t minus 6 sine 200 t. So this is the expression for VC of t. Now you substitute VC of 1 millisecond. You just solve that. You substitute t equal to 1 millisecond. And this will be e power minus 100 into 1 millisecond. And 2 cos this t, again 1 millisecond you have to substitute. Here also you have to substitute to 1 millisecond. Then you calculate, you will get the value for VC of 1 millisecond. I think you will get to 0.694. You just verify, you will get around this value. Okay.